Hey Liu, you are a qualified financial advisor, right?
Yes, what is this about?
Need quick advice here.
Shoot!
I'm 45 this year, in a stable mid-management level career, but don't seem to have enough money to retire at 50. Thinking to refinance my house to cash out and invest into maybe stocks, maybe real estate, I don't know. If stocks, what stocks to buy? If property, then which area to buy?
Hold on. What are your goals in the first place?
Want to be rich lah, and not work anymore.
Duh, I don't want to be rich, says nobody ever.
Seriously, have you drafted a plan to achieve that specific goal?
Is becoming rich not a goal?
Nope, I mean smart goals.
Specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-bound.
Like what?
Like this. I plan to stop working in 8 years' time, having X amount of money by then to generate Y amount of passive dividends until age 80, after spending Z amount of money to fund my children's education.
Hiya, so complicated. I don't have one and I don't need one. I just need your direct answer. What to invest in now? Your advice on what is the best to invest in?
But without a goal and a plan, that is like you having the money, but you
walk into an air ticketing counter at the airport to buy an air ticket to nowhere. No destination, no itinerary.
Look, my personal life is none of your business, okay? I need investment advice, not personal advice.
Dude, investment advice is personal advice.
Okay, screw this. Bye-bye.
A few moments later.
Howdy, gents. I need investment advice. Don't give me personal advice, huh?
Hey, doctor. Chest pain What medicine to take?
Come, lie down and let me check.
Don't touch me.
What is your past medical history?
I don't want to tell you lah. Just prescribe me the medicine for chest pain. Can already.
Sir, I don't think this is gonna work.
Can you see how dumb that is? Same with financial products. That is why people investing journey are going nowhere except in circles. Due to SOS, shiny object syndrome. Same analogy, you plan the dish you're going to cook and how to cook it. Then you source for the right ingredients in the right proportion and you choose the right cooking appliances to cook it. Let me show you how personal this can get using the ocean analogy. On the surface of the ocean, the sunlight zone, you have your investment and insurance. And most people assume that's all to it. You go down one level into the twilight zone, that is when you have your financial scenario analysis, like what age to start working so you could sustain your retirement until say age 80 with no active income, or to restructure an underperforming investment or restructure an overpay or irrelevant insurance policies to boost your cash flow without jeopardizing your protection. Then you go another level deeper, the dark zone, where things get scarier. Because at this level, it deals with behavioral finance. Your compulsive spending habit, your irrational fear of investing, your obsession with treating the stock market like a casino. Things that are catastrophic to your personal finances, hampering your financial progress or wealth accumulation, even though you earn 5-6 figures a month. I have observed this before, a client that earns 6 figures per month but can only save less than 1,000 a month. And finally, the abyss, the ocean floor is where it can be traced back. Why we behave certain ways about money, our deepest, darkest desires, and all other inner demons represented by this giant squid or Loch Ness monster. Are you really seeing money as the ultimate goal in life, or are you just using it as a tool? Are you treating money with abundance mindset or scarcity mindset? How we see and treat money is shaped by our belief system about money, influenced by the stories we tell ourselves during our upbringing, and sometimes due to trauma, which I explain more in this next video. More info in the description below.